I'm currently mixing up another batch of smoke bombs. In this test, I'll be testing different additives, a follow-on from episode 4. What I'll be testing is, so I have one which is just kind of the straight, and I'm going to be using a 62.5 percent potassium nitrate and 35.7% sugar. Then I'll be adding 3 grams of additives, bringing the total amount in each batch up to 23 grams. The first additive I'll be testing is just adding an additional 3 grams of sugar, bringing the ratio down to about 55% potassium nitrate, 45% sugar. And the reason there's so much background noise is that they're chopping our field right now. I'll then be testing salt, baking soda, and some of the aluminum potassium sulfate that I used to fireproof cloth. Each of these I'm doing 2 batches of, and I'm using the dissolve method, dissolving it and boiling off the water. The reason I'm using 2 batches is to test consistency. This isn't perfect, like 3 batches or even more would be ideal, but this is doing 9 different things, and that's, I just don't want to do more than that. That is the limit I think I can get myself to do. The reason I'm using this slightly different ratio than the 60% potassium nitrate, 40% sugar that I've normally used is from my ratio test, it seems to me it works a little bit better than the 60% potassium nitrate that I'd previously used. In an attempt to make these test results better, I am rinsing the pot and the spoon I'm using between tests of different additives. I'm not rinsing between the 2 batches of the same additives, but I am rinsing when I change additives. So when I use the aluminum potassium sulfate, it created a really different, it kind of foamed up really badly and actually kind of burnt, so I did have to rinse it out between the 2 of them. And it's like really kind of foamy and really weird. I haven't seen anything else like it. I don't know how to describe it. Like, this is soft. I'll need to wrap this up soon. But this is like super dry and crunchy. I don't know. We'll see how it burns, but I probably won't be using it again because it went from happily boiling away in a not exactly thick liquid to like suddenly being all foamy and burning like within like 10 seconds when I happen to be looking away.
even now, I don't think it's burned fully.
I'm gonna get a stick this time. I guess that did actually burn basically fully the second time.
The remains from this alum test are really like crispy and like odd, like very aerated crispy. And also like super white. It's really interesting. This test as a whole was very interesting, and I'm definitely going to try it again with the ground.
The alum was the most fire retardant additive, though it is unclear if this is purely due to its chemical nature or because of the issues I had with final boiling down, resulting in some potential residual water in the samples. It produced so little smoke and so much of it remained that I doubt the entire amount of sugar combusted. The baking soda also exhibited fire retardant properties, not nearly as severe as the alum, but similar to the previous similar ratio additive test. The salt, on the other hand, did not behave similarly to previous additive tests and retarded fire much less than I was expecting. The extra sugar behaved very similarly to previous tests with a similar ratio to what it was burning at. Particularly noticeable was the dark smoke that happens with these high sugar content tests. I've previously observed, though it has not always shown up on camera, dark smoke from the dissolved 50 and 45% sugar tests. This is by far the most obvious to show up on camera. One of the issues with comparing this test to previous tests is that I used slightly higher potassium nitrate in the base ratios. Though this may have given me the greater reliability I was searching for, it also means I cannot directly compare with the previous additives tests. Another issue with comparison is between tests from multiple days. This test and the one previous were lit off in calm air, whereas most of the ones before these two tests were on days with at least some wind. Though this does not affect the burning, it does affect the perceived smoke, one of the factors I am trying to analyze. With these most recent tests, it hung around where previously it was quickly blown away. At least within this test, the repetitive tests I did with the same additive acted very similar between the two ignitions, which shows some consistency. My hypothesis that the type of additive would not matter is clearly incorrect, with distinct differences observed between the additives. With the interesting results from the ground ratio testing, I have to wonder how much every little thing affects various aspects. Too much and overwhelming to test them all. You may notice that I'm in a different spot than normal. That's because there's a robin's nest really close to where I normally do this, only about 3 to 4 feet away. This gives me an extra, I don't know, 15 feet beyond that, so I'm choosing to be here to give them a little bit more space. Enjoy some photos of them.